Bem-vindos, and welcome to my channel. New year, new plan. Continuing with my idea of dividing projects up into multiple shorter episodes, here we are for part two of Behold the Beholder. The Beholder Fights Back. The project is Rallycor, Lord of the Beholders by Stormborn Collectibles on minifactory.com. It's a wonderfully scary version of my favorite D&D monster. As I said last time, I set out to make this a speed paint project, but as early as the priming phase, I realized that this would need some standard paint finishing touches. But I wanted to get as much detail as I could with the speed paints first, so I trudged on. I prefer to start my minis with a base because it gives me a good idea of the environment the monster is in, as well as using the colors on the base to enhance the monster and help it make it stand out. Once I was satisfied with the base, it was time to move on to the main mini. I specifically kept the head split into two so I could focus on the detail of the mouth without having to struggle reaching all the spots with the brush. This worked out extremely well, and I'm very satisfied with how it turned out. Once I was done with the mouth, it was time to connect the headpieces and work on the main body of the Mini. There was an issue with the pieces not fitting together smoothly, which I find happens sometimes in printed Minis. I quickly went to work to sand, cut, and shape the pieces as best I could. I then used a little bit of Milliput to fill in the gap, smoothed out the surface, and let it sit overnight. When I picked it up the next day, it only took a little bit of work to get it as close to seamless as possible, and then I was ready to reprime the Milliput section and continue painting. Once I had the head completed to my satisfaction, it was time to work on the eye stalks. This was probably the most time-consuming part of the project, as I went over each eye stalk once, set it aside to dry, and then gave them a second coat just to even out the skin. While I was happy with the outcome overall, I knew I could do better and decided it was time to put the speed paints away and break out the wet palette. But that's a story for another day. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed my little video. Please post your feedback in the comments below. Yes, I do read them. Tell me what you liked, what you didn't like, and what you want to see in the future. If you haven't subscribed yet, please hit that magic button and do so, as I hope to have an amazing year and want you all to join me. Also, like and share the video to help me broaden my audience. Join me next time as I finish out this beast of a mini. Until then, remember, they ain't gonna paint themselves.